big warm welcome to you all. Thanks for joining me again. Well, I was at Manchester over the weekend. I was at an event called For the Love of Sci-Fi. Now, Peter Weller was there, aka RoboCop. And it's not the first time I've met Peter Weller. I've met him before in London. Amazing day. But this time round was absolutely amazing. It was dreamland material for me. I can't describe how I felt. It was amazing. But I just want to basically just talk about the day. What was happening, who I met, stuff like that. I met the boys first, Dave and Wes. Known them for a very long time on Facebook. We've never actually met. But big RoboCop fans, those guys have suits as well. And yeah, we met up for the first time, and it was like we've been friends for years and years and years, the way we were speaking. And it was absolutely fantastic. It was great, you know. I let them hold me RoboCop merchandises and stuff like that, and they were very humble, and they loved it, absolutely loved it, and that's what it's all about. It was an absolutely fantastic day with them boys, so thank you very much, boys, if you watch this video. Thank you. I totally enjoyed myself around your company. It was brilliant. I can't wait to do it again with you guys. That's how great it was. But as we set the suit up in the, because it was supposed to be at the side of Ed 209 apparently at first, but I wasn't happy where the suit was going to be located, so I moved it to the corner. And I could not be any happier because Peter Weller was at the side of me. Well, it was the next table up, but it was like from me to, you know, from that wall to that wall, probably about 8 foot, 9 foot. That's how close he was to Peter Weller all day. Dreamland. Well, Peter Weller was a bit mardy that day. You know, I don't know if he had an illness or whatever, but he was like, no photos, no photos. I was like, you tell Peter's here, because that's what he's always like. He hates photos, you know. You have to respect him a little bit, right? But, like I say, we got the suit set up. When he first came in, he saw the suit and he had a little bit of a smile on his face. But sat down, signed autographs. There was a team of lads, Christopher and his team, the RoboDoc. First time I met these boys, they came across and they was absolutely fantastic, lads, absolutely fantastic. We had some good talks, had some laughs with them. But the RoboDoc, basically who these guys are, they've done a full documentary on RoboCop from the first movie, second and third. They've interviewed all the actors, they've interviewed all the actors from the TV series as well, so they've covered the full RoboCop franchise. And I'd take my hat off to them boys. That is some doing, absolute some doing. And they only needed Peter Weller. That's when they needed to complete this video. And oh, they was on proper hunt material that day. There was like an eagle going in for the prey. And Peter knew who these guys were. And it was actually quite funny because the RoboDoc gave a 20-minute preview. It was supposed to be half an hour, I think it was. They gave a preview of it. Dr. Weller, as he likes to be called now, and he's on stage, and yeah, Peter wasn't playing ball. He knew, but I was having a good laugh watching over at the suit light. Yeah, it was fantastic, absolutely fantastic. But I wish those boys, you know, all the luck in the world, and I hope they do get Peter Weller. If any of you big hardcore RoboCop fans are, you know, can help out or whatever, I will put their link in the description so you can check those guys out. Fantastic guys, absolutely fantastic, like I say. And I just want to support them a little bit, give them a shout out. But like I say, for me to meet them guys, fantastic. Very humble, you know, around them lads. Like I say, they went off and then it was just like me with a suit next to Peter. And what happened was, your mate Wes was in the line, because I only had some limited autographs off Peter Weller. So I'm saving them. What happened was, I seen my mate Wes in the line, being a bit cheeky as I am, because I couldn't, obviously I couldn't leave the suit. So I saw Wes in the line, I went, Wes up? Yeah. So I took the Robocop head over to him, and he got him to sign this, but it was so funny, because when Peter Weller was signing, Wes is, you know, giving him the autograph, he was going to put on the head, two Wes, Dr. Peter Weller Robo, and Wes was like, no, mate, just Peter Weller Robo, that'll do, mate. Yeah, that was quite comical, because it could have been made out to Wes. But thank you very much, Wes, for doing that for me, thank you. So yeah, I got the screen used cast. I don't want to cause any complications, but this is a cast off the original mould. So, like I say, I'm very humbled to have this piece, so thank you very much, Julian. Big respect to you. So yeah, got it signed. And this is off on the display wall, because I'm going to be altering this wall soon. So this is going on there, can't wait. Well, I wanted to get it all painted, but the head didn't come in time, so I was like, well, that'll never get painted now, that'll stay as it is. Not really bothered. But I say, as the day went on, I got my photograph took with Peter Weller. As you can see on this one, me and Peter with the head 209. The head 209 was alright, you know, for a 3 week build. Wouldn't really fault it, it was pretty good, you know. So, well done to those guys, by the way. Yeah, like I say, I got my photo took with Peter Weller. That was another magic moment, absolutely brilliant. And as the day went on, I actually plucked up some courage, because I was quite nervous, you know what I mean, because he was a big Mardy. And I walked over to Peter with this chin piece and I showed him it, and he started looking at it and he went, yeah, it's definitely authentic. And the more he looked at it, he went, how did you get this? And I went, don't ask Peter. I said, I nearly got booted out of the house for it. So he started having a bit of a laugh about it, like. So yeah, he went, you've got some nice pieces there. I went, oh, thank you. And like I say, he signed it as well with a special marker pen. He insisted on getting the right pen for this chin piece. Yeah, he signed it. I'm delighted. Absolutely dreamland again. So this piece has now been signed. And what happened was, once he signed that book, the story behind it all was Peter Weller was in the line first, signing, you know, everybody else's autograph. So I knew we worked it out, we got something sorted for, because my dream was always Peter Weller to come over to me, sign my suit, and have his photo took with my suit and me at the side of him. That was always my number one goal. That was my dream, to have that one photograph. And that magic moment came. He came over, he signed the chin piece first, and then he stood. He went straight up to the Robocop suit, as you've seen the pictures, and he signed my suit. He actually signed it. And I was in dreamland. I didn't know what to say, I was like, just gobsmacked. That's how magic moment it was. So yeah, he signed it, and then you see the little video as well. He came over, we both went to the Robocop suit, and obviously behind the barrier there's everybody, and they're all, I told him, I said, oh lads, I went, will you take loads of photos and send me it please? So I've got like multiple angles, it was like a paparazzi. It was brilliant. And yeah, we got, I stood there, and that was it. Me and Peter Weller, Dr. Weller now, we got a photo took, and absolute dreamland. That moment I would cherish for the rest of my life. It was absolutely awesome. But, you know, I've done it, I've done my dream. And that's what it's all about. And I say for you guys, if you've got a dream, just keep going, never quit, just keep going. And I got mine, like I say, I'm going to cherish this for the rest of my life. And the best thing about it was, my son was with me as well, and he saw that moment. And it might not mean much to him at the moment, but when he gets older, you know, and I'm old and frail, he'll be like, wow, Dad, I can't believe he did that. And that's what it's all about. So that's another magic moment for me, my son watching me with a legend, aka RoboCop, Peter Weller. And like I say, I'm very humbled for the weekend. I didn't know how it was going to go. It was unplanned. And just magic, absolutely magic. And then at the end of the day, probably about 4, I think that was about 5 o'clock time, I went over to Peter Weller and I took him this photograph. It was only because I see Dave, because Dave went, oh, I just had to get that photo. I had to get the autograph on his photo. So sorry, Dave, I did nick your idea. And I couldn't help myself. I thought, Dave's not getting one over on me. So I went straight over and I got him to sign a personal message on this for me. And he's done it for me. Absolutely brilliant. So I got a few autographs that day and made me dream. And that's what it's all about. Loved it. Absolutely loved it. So I can't really say a lot on the map, really. I'm just humble, absolutely humble. I've done my dream, that's it. And, you know, like I said, I wish the Robo Doc, every success. I hope they succeed, and I really, really do hope that you get Peter Weller, because that will put the icing on the cake on that documentary. Like I say, check those guys out, you know, have a look at their video, what they're doing about it. You'll like it if you're into RoboCop. Or if you're not, if you just like Robo, just have a watch of it. Like I say, support those guys, they're absolutely brilliant. Like I say, once again, thanks Dave, Wes. Thank you to Lee for coming with me as well. That was his first time at a Comic-Con. Absolutely fantastic. My mate Tony came with me as well. We all chipped in, we all did a bit. We all did our shift. But like I said, for me, all the sci-fi, first time I've been at their event, I enjoyed it. It was a good Comic-Con. You know, we met a few stars, Dolph Lundgren, and the Punisher from the series, the little midget, and the Willow and all that lot. My mind's gone blank. But yeah, we met him, and then as the day was going on, Danny Glover was just sat there. He had no autographs at the time, so he was just sat there having a nana nap, I think, and I sort of interrupted him. I went, Danny, says, can I have a photo took with you, mate? I mean, Danny Glover, absolute legend, isn't he? You know, Lethal Weapon and Predator and all the other magnificent movies he's done. But for me, it's always Lethal Weapon and Predator 2. So I had my photo took with him. And he was a true gentleman, absolute true gentleman. He shook his hand and was talking and he went,
did you watch Jumanji?
I said, yes, I have seen it, Danny. He went, you wreck. And I went, I said, it was all right, mate. I said, he's not as good as the first one, though. And he looked at me, gone out. I said, I'm just kidding, mate. But yeah, Danny Glover, absolute legend. Like I say, brilliant bloke. I think in his now, because I asked him, I said, Danny, I went, are you going to be doing a new Lethal Weapon 5? And he went, yeah. I was like, ah, go on, mate. Him and Mel Gibson back, brilliant. Like I say, the day was absolutely fantastic. Like I say, I got all my parts done. I got the chin guard signed, and I got the head signed. Like I say, I wanted to get this painted, but like I say, it's going to stay as it is. And I just couldn't pick an absolute legend of the day. Unplanned days are always the best days, you know. But like I say, when Peter Weller came over, it, like I say, wasn't mad. But everyone was like, no way. He went, how did you get Peter Weller over here? Everyone was just shocked that Peter Weller came over to me. It was like, they don't normally do that. But like I say, Peter Weller actually sees this video. Thank you very much, mate. You're an absolute legend. And I hope you do the new RoboCop movie. Go on, mate. Get it done. Yeah, brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Can't thank Peter enough. I hope he comes back to the UK again. I will say is I'm sorry about the background noise with the 3D printer going, but the reason the printers are going at the moment is because I'm building a full-size cane from RoboCop 2. So that's going to be a few Comic Cons next year when it gets done. If any of you guys are not familiar with Kane, there's the big boy here. So that's getting done. Looking forward to doing that build. It's going to be amazing, absolutely amazing. Yeah, that's all I can say really. It's just, like I say, if you've got a dream, just go for it. Don't hold back, just keep pushing for it. One day you will succeed. I've been, 32 years now, I've been supporting RoboCop franchise, and I've done it. I've got the dream. I've done my dream. So, on that bomb note, that is me signing out. Thank you very much for watching, and keep supporting the channel, guys, if you can. I appreciate every subscriber. You know, thank you very much. And there's going to be, like I said, there's going to be exciting things happening next year. You know, I've got the full-size RoboCop cane to build. My Batman Tumbler car's coming on now. I've just picked up some new parts from the machine yard. All the front end's done now, so those videos will be coming. I've got some new cameras now as well, so getting all that set up. I'm still building the studio. The alterations, it's starting to become something now, and I'm enjoying it. I'm actually enjoying sharing my work with you guys. It's fantastic. So that's me, Defo, signing off now. Like I said, RoboDoc crew, thank you very much, guys. Total respect. Peter Weller, legend. To the boys and everyone, thank you very much, and I'll see you soon on the next video.